In today's tutorial, you'll learn advanced ways of how to add texture in Photoshop. I'll show you how to create a custom texture brush, how to create different texture effects, and we'll share a special photo texturing method that will change your workflow completely. You'll be able to use tips from this Photoshop tutorial even if you're a beginner, and we'll make your own illustrations much better. You're watching TNT Tutorials, let's move on! Let's create a custom texture brush first. Create a new document with 500 pixels and draw any shape you want. I recommend you to make something like this. After this, go to Edit, Define Brush Preset, and rename your brush. Brush is done, and now we need a texture for it. Download any texture that you want and make it seamless. Go to Filter, Other, Offset, move these sliders a bit to see seams better, pick the stamp tool and remove seams. Don't be too precise, we simply need to get rid of rough transitions. You can turn on offset again to check if any seams left, edit them if needed, go to Edit, Define Pattern and rename your pattern. Now we can select texture brush in the brushes panel and open brush settings. All you need to adjust is spacing and texture. In spacing, I usually use value from 15 to 6. Talking about texture settings, I almost always use only one brush and simply play with these values all the time. I also play with textures, so it's better to create and upload from 5 to 10 different textures if you want to have a real fun. I change settings for texture brush almost for each new shape, and here's how you can do this. Try how your brush looks, play with sliders and textures, and try your brush again, until you'll get what you want. To make a see-through texture, click on this little icon to turn off shape dynamics, and play with texture sliders to get texture like this. Apply texture by clicking, and don't worry if texture goes over the borders of the needed object. To make a hard edge, use Pen to select object, hold Ctrl or Command and click on icon in the Path panel to make selection active. Press Ctrl or Command plus Shift plus I to invert selection and press Delete. To make a soft edge, let's apply Mask by clicking on this little icon, pick black color, adjust texture brush settings and move with brush along the edge. To quickly add noise texture, go to Filter, Noise, Add Noise, and play with sliders. But we have much more interesting ways to add noise texture. Let's enter Filter Gallery, select Texture, Grain. In Grain type you have many options, so I'll show you how to make a combination of two of them. Let's pick Enlarge, use these values, and click OK. Then enter Filter Gallery again and choose Soft with the same values. This is the result. There's no need to create a custom noise brush when you want to use it. Create a new layer and click between two layers to make clipping mask. In blending mode, select Dissolve. Pick standard airbrush and enjoy drawing noise shadows or highlights. Let me show you a special photo texturing method that few people know about. First that you need to do is to save all needed photo textures as PSD files. Then select needed object, enter Filter Gallery, and in Texture, select Texturizer. Click on this little menu and load your photo texture. Now you can use these sliders to adjust it, play with light, and even invert your photo texture. I'll show a few close-ups of my illustration for those who want to take a closer look and analyze my texturing methods. Don't forget to press thumbs up if you learned something new from this tutorial, and also subscribe so you don't miss more useful tutorials like this. This was TNT Tutorials, thank you for watching and see you in the next video!